Hey folks, my name is Sally Hendrick, and I'm going to do a presentation for you today on everything you need in your business to be able to sell courses online, to sell your expertise, et cetera, et cetera. This is all about marketing, your website, your blog, your content marketing, all of those types of things, okay? So bear with me a second. I will get things rolling. Okay, I've got my presentation here and I'm going to load it up so you can see it. Let me make sure I get to the beginning of the presentation. All right. Okay, here we go. We're at the beginning. All right, this is the digital stuff that you need to sell your expertise easily, quickly, and mostly hands off. And I say mostly because it would be awesome if we could just hand everything off, but that's kind of unrealistic. We do have to stay in tune with what's going on with our businesses. All right, the agenda today, we're going to talk about website and blog, course platform, email management, customer journey, that's also called sales funnel, payment processing, event management, automations and integrations, tracking and analytics. That's my favorite, tracking and analytics, all right? So your website and blog, this is your content marketing hub. This is basically the types of pages and the types of things that you need to be concerned about when it comes to your website. You need a home page, an about page, a blog, contact page, terms and privacy pages, that's a legal requirement, and then tracking and analytics. Now, all I'm really going to say about this is that this is where you present who you are as a brand, you know, your business model, et cetera. The about page is going to be a page that does tell things about you, but it also tells how you help people, okay? So you kind of make that into a creative story, if you will. The blog is going to be the content that you are producing on a regular basis. And this is really important because if you want to be found online through Google searching or Bing searching or any of the search engines, a blog shows those search engines that your content is relevant and current and consistent. That will help you rise in the rankings. As far as a contact page, people have to know how to get in touch with you. Now, not everybody has their phone number or their email or a form on their website. However, if you do have a way for people to maybe sometimes you need an application process where people need to apply to get on your calendar or apply to be able to have an appointment with you, if you will, because you need to qualify people sometimes. Terms and privacy, again, that's a legal requirement, just the terms and conditions of your business and then the privacy policy. That's required for all websites. And then tracking and analytics, again, really important, my favorite part. That's where you can see where people are visiting your website, what they're doing on it, and it gives you an idea of what's working, what's not working, and what you may need to highlight in a different way. As far as back to the homepage, that homepage is just going to be like, what's that most important thing that you want people to take that first step doing? You either want to give them a smattering of what your business is about, or you want to immediately send them into some sort of funnel to get them to go down a customer journey, which we'll talk about in a minute. Hold on, it keeps jumping. Going faster than I want it to. Okay, that's right. All right, so now we're going to talk about the course platform, Teach and Assess. Because we're talking about Kajabi, which is a software that I use in a few minutes, we're going to talk about other pieces of software as well. I want to show you the types of things that you need to have when you are offering courses or, you know, any kind of knowledge-based system where you've got to teach somebody something. Maybe it's proprietary information for your business that you want your vendors to have. Maybe it is information that you need your clients to have before you have a coaching session with them. Or maybe it's just information they need to know so that your working relationship together, is much, much better. Or maybe you're just putting courses out there that people just buy, period. Okay? So you need a dashboard. You need the instructor information. You need modules, lessons, announcements to send to the students, a video program. That's so you have a place to store your videos and upload them. Document downloads, that's really important. Most courses are going to have something that people need to download to study or to review or to put up on the wall, whatever that may be. Drips and lock functions are really fun. They're really great to do because you can just disseminate the information in a way that people have to finish something before they move forward. Or if you lock something, that's because maybe you've done an assessment and they need to pass that assessment before the next module opens up. So that functionality is there. Assessments, of course, that's really important to be able to assess the knowledge that your customers have come through to get. And then certificates, you can attach that part to your courses. And then, of course, tracking and analytics. As always, you can see progress reports on your students, and you can look to see, where are people falling off? Where may they need extra instruction or something like that? The next thing is email management. Communicate and inform. With the email management system, you want to have a visual editor because you want to be able to, maybe bold some things, make it bigger, maybe add some color or add some imagery to your emails. Maybe make it like a newsletter so that it's a little bit more formatted, almost like a miniature web page, if you will. Broadcast are single emails to your list or to a segment of your list. Sequences are when you take people down a pathway of emails to get them to maybe get to know you a little bit better, maybe let them understand your business a little bit better, maybe teach them something along the way, send them to your social media or to some valuable videos or whatever you may have. A welcome sequence is obviously very popular when people come on your list. It's like, hey, who are you and what's going on and what are you doing? Automations, that's really important to have in your email management. If you have automations, you can add in these if this, then that statements to be able to make sure you're tracking people properly or tagging them or whatever. And the tagging system is important. And then tracking and analytics once again. Customer journey. This is the sales funnel or pipeline that you may or may not have heard about. This is really important for when you are getting ready to actually grow your email list, pitch an offer to your audience, whatever that may be. You need to have some sort of sales funnel or pipeline, which is basically a digital customer journey. Now, if you look at this chart on the right, this is actually a chart that I made, and I make it for my clients. Whenever they come to me, they will have a landing page. They'll have a thank you page, all these different things and these things that you have to go through to be able to send your customer down a pathway that has different ways to go depending on the actions they take. And then this is how you can warm them up and have them get to know you better, trust that you have their solution, and then sell them something. And then you actually make some money. All right. So the landing page, that's one of the first things we can chit chat about. I'm not going to go into too many details, but this is the page that you send people to, that they come to when they are looking for something in particular. Like maybe let's say that you have a downloadable resource that's free or very inexpensive, an introductory type thing that you want to send to them so that they will download it. Now, they have to put their email address in and get on your email list so that you can then send them to a thank you page that has more information on it to tell them what to do next. You'll also be sending them emails along with that. So emails will start going out once they sign up on your landing page and then land on your thank you page. Those emails will start to disseminate to nurture them. You can also have nurture pages. Basically, when people get an email and it says, go watch this video, you will learn X, Y, or Z. And that could be on one of your landing pages on your website. At some point, you're going to want to pitch an offer, and sometimes people do it right away at the beginning, but most of the time, if it's a longer nurture process, the bigger offer is going to be offered on a sales page, and then you have a checkout page where if they're ready to buy, they will go to the checkout page to input their payment details. You may want to have the coupon functionality. You also may want to have an order bump functionality, meaning that they're going to go to the checkout page, they're going to buy something from you, and in the corner there may be a little boxed check that says, add this for only so many dollars more, and you get this complimentary offer that goes along with your main offer, okay? And then after they check out there, you can even go to an upsell to sell them something even bigger or something else that goes along with what it is that you started selling up here. You know, these different types of extra things to sell. Those can do really well. And then after someone purchases, they can go to a purchase confirmation page. Once they reach that confirmation page, that tells your system and it tells the tracking and analytics that this person actually became a paying customer. And it also gives them information that's really important for them to know what to do next. Like, go check your email to make sure you can log in. Or maybe here's the video with instructions on what to do next. Whatever it is, you can be as creative as you want on that purchase confirmation page. And then, of course, like I always end, there's tracking and analytics, which is crucial for measuring sales funnels, success rate, if you will, and to know where things are working and where they're not. All right, the next thing on the agenda is the payment processing. This is where you get paid and where maybe you might have some taxes that have to be paid, and that's typically for services. You're not going to be dealing with that in the United States, but if you are doing something in another country, you may have a tax element that goes along with it, and that's what TaxJar is for. But Stripe and PayPal are going to be your two main payment processors. You can try to incorporate other things into it if you'd like, but this will, once you set these up with Kajabi, there's no more integration. You will always have these options on your checkout pages. Event management. All right, so you're invited to a webinar or a meeting. And whenever people put on webinars or meetings, they want to be able to have people register specifically for those things. Just like this presentation, I'm starting out as a live webinar to potential customers or clients who want to possibly buy a system using my affiliate link. I'm going to be doing this webinar or conducting this meeting in order to teach something so that you guys can understand what it is that you may need. All right, so emails to register, reminders, and selling emails can all be attached to an event, the event management system within different pieces of software. It just so happens that Kajabi has this included as well. You can also embed live video. You can even embed recorded video. I forgot to put that on here. Also, the countdown timers can come with the events. That's really helpful because you can refer to a specific event within the Kajabi's email system, for example, and it will use the countdown timer for that particular event. So you don't have to worry about maybe messing up some of the details as you're loading it in. As long as you choose the right event to go to, then it will fix the countdown timer to be exactly what you need it to be. Automatic offer expiration. Sometimes it really helps that if your offer is going to expire at midnight on a certain day, you don't want to have to be up at 11:59 p.m. waiting for the clock to tick down to have to go and change a web page to not be available anymore or to redirect somewhere else. So they build that in as an automation to either turn a feature off or turn a section on, turn another section off so that it will be ready to go for you automatically when the timer runs out. And of course, tracking and analytics. Automations and integrations. Now, this is where you can get pretty detailed. I only put a few things on here because there's just like nearly an unlimited potential on this. This is basically the if this, then that statement type of thing that you would be putting together. So an automation, for example, would be tag this person with a little label that you name yourself when a certain action is taken, such as and granting access to or removing an offer from a particular person if they take a certain action. You can also send an email when an action is taken. You can add them to an email sequence when an action is taken. There's all kinds of things that you can do. And you can even put conditions on it, meaning tag this person, and then there'll be a condition that says, unless they've already bought this program, you know, for example. So there's all kinds of things you can do. Add to or remove from an email sequence, add to or remove from an event, tag when someone clicks a link, send certificate upon completion and assessment, you know, maybe the assessment was passed. So all of these types of things are included, and there's no extra software required to integrate either, which is really cool because if you were having to integrate with other programs, like an email program, or maybe you were going to integrate with your website because your website's on WordPress, but your marketing system and your course system is on Kajabi, you wouldn't have to do all these integrations to make these things talk to each other. It's all included inside. You don't even have to integrate with what's happening on the payment side of things. If someone bought a course or did something already and you don't want them to get emails to sell it to them again, you can have all of that easily integrated. And in the past, it was always such a technical headache to be able to make all of that happen. Most people don't know how to do that. And it becomes really expensive when you have to hire someone else to do those things. That's why I love this program. Okay, so tracking and analytics, the thing I mention on pretty much every page. This is basically know your KPIs, which are your key performance indicators. They are crucial for your success. Google Analytics is one way of measuring what people are clicking on and what they're doing on your website. Facebook Pixel, that is installed very easily on your website over the entire thing. And built-in standard events are automated. This is really, really great because a lot of people don't even realize what this is until they get to the point where they're ready to start doing Facebook advertising and or even Instagram advertising. And what happens is this is an advanced form of Facebook pixel events, if you will, that measure how deep people are going into your website. And if that's not set up, your Facebook ads don't do nearly as well as they should. So to have this be an automated thing that's built in is so cool. And it always makes it easier for me as an advertising agency to be able to know that if my clients use this software, I have a lot less technical headaches to worry about, a lot less auditing to deal with. And it really is great. Email analytics, that's another thing really important. You want to know who opens your emails. You want to know who unsubscribes. Or maybe you don't want to know. You just don't want to pay attention to them. But you want to know, what is it that's making people unsubscribe? Or what is it headlines or titles in your subject lines are not working, whereas another one works better, you have a higher percentage open rate? Or what if people are not clicking on the links inside your email? You want to know who is and who isn't so that you can filter people into the ones that you really need to be talking to, okay? And then as far as page analytics go, you want to know what's happening on your web pages, how many people are landing on it, how many people are maybe taking action, filling out a form and moving to the next step, and how many are not, and who is and who isn't. And then funnel analytics, that's where you get into the sales funnel with all of the bells and whistles, and you want to be able to know every little segment, what's working and what's not. Okay, so what I want to talk to you about right now before we finish up on this presentation, I actually run a club. It's a content marketing club. It's called the Exponential Marketing Club. It's basically business and marketing coaching. I do some advertising coaching in there from time to time, though it's not the focus of this particular group. It's more about your organic content marketing. It's about what you're going to write on your blogs, how you're going to make your videos for your social media, how you need to connect things up, those types of things, what content is effective and what's not, et cetera. So that club you can get into free for 3 months. It comes with a content marketing dashboard, a sales funnel course, a Facebook ads course. For now, at least, I am planning on pulling that out and making it a separate thing. Copy and design tips, live coaching, a Facebook group, and then, of course, networking connections. It's great when you get into a group. Those connections with other people that are doing the same thing you are can be very valuable to your business. Now, at the bottom here, it says sallyhendrick.com/Kajabi. That is my affiliate link, and I want to just point that out to you. I will make commission if you purchase Kajabi, and when you do, just know that you're coming into my membership as well, and I can offer you a little bit of support in there for the Kajabi setup, in addition to what Kajabi does when they onboard you. They really help you. They have a lot of great training. The other thing that I'm going to give you if you decide to use my affiliate link is get clear on clients and offers. This is customized clarity. You will know all the questions that must be answered before someone will become your customer or client. You will get to fill out our detailed clarity journal, submit it to us, and we will return your answers to you for your reference. That way, you don't lose it just because you filled out the form and sent it to me. You need to get those answers back. You work hard on that questionnaire. It takes a while to do the questionnaire. I give you a practice document, and then you come bring it back to the web page and you input it into the page. And when you do and submit that to me, I package it up neatly and send it back to you in a nice, neat email so that you will always have that information moving forward. Now, I want to show you a little bit about the comparison to some of the more popular course and marketing funnel products. Nothing else really compares. Kajabi is a fully integrated system, but I want to show you what some of these other things do. And I'm also going to send you to a link to go back to look at some of the videos that show a better comparison than what I'm doing right now. So Teachable, it's pretty much a course platform. It's not, it kind of can be a website in a way, but it's not a blog. You have to do multiple integrations to be able to do marketing emails and all these other things. You can do course emails, but like informing your students, but as far as like getting customers, that part's not included. Limited marketing functionality. There's just very little around that. It is a great course platform for just doing courses. That's what I would say. But as far as like you know, getting people online to come and buy your course on Teachable is going to be harder because you've got a lot more systems you have to integrate. Thinkific, this is a great course platform. However, there's no app. Kajabi has an app for their clients. For all of our students, you can log into the Kajabi app and get your materials there that we put together. It's very mobile friendly, our courses are. There's no blog. It requires multiple integrations, limited marketing functionality. So again, it's kind of similar to Teachable, though I do think that it's probably a little bit better of a course program, if you will. I also think, and I'm not sure if they still do this, but Teachable used to take money from your income to cover certain expenses and on their end. So they take a slice of your course charge, you know, whatever you're charging for your course. That's in exchange basically for a lower level of their product. So when you get a higher level of their product that costs you more per month, I think that function goes away. On ClickFunnels, ClickFunnels is not going to be for your website, for your blog. It's not going to be for your courses or a membership site or anything like that, like Kajabi will. It's a great sales and marketing system, but again, it requires multiple integrations, whereas Kajabi is not going to require that. All right, so if you go to sallyhendrick.com/Kajabi, again, you're going to be seeing this deal. But if you want to watch these comparison videos that Kajabi has put together that are really great, that show you the differences between Teachable, Thinkific, and ClickFunnels, go to sallyhendrick.com/compare, and you'll see that. Okay, so on the last thing, this is just gives you a general overview of what all is included with Kajabi. First of all, you get to get Kajabi for $99 for 3 months. This deal expires July 26th. I have never seen this pricing like this before. That's only $33 a month. And that's pretty insane for this majorly powerful program. You'll get a supportive Kajabi community. You get live chat and or email support, depending on the level you're at. You have an active group of Kajabi users, tons of templates to choose from, meaning like sales pages or course pages or themes, website pages, opt-ins, landing pages, thank you pages, you know, whatever it is. You know, they even have the courses, like you go and choose the type of course you want to do, and they will choose the best method for you to get that set up. It's automated advanced Facebook tracking. They have that. Highly customizable mobile app for students. Multiple products, product types, including community. So not only do you have courses, but you also have a community function, which is like a community group, kind of like a Facebook group, but it's not quite the level of a Facebook group. But there's often times that you do not want to have Facebook distractions for your group. So a community on Kajabi as one of your products could be very helpful. And then they just added a podcasting feature to the platform, which I'm super excited about because I do have a couple of podcasts going out there. And this is going to save me a lot of money in other programs that I'm using. So overall, save a ton of time, money, and headaches, especially the headaches for getting Kajabi. Now remember, this deal expires July 26th, and I can guarantee you this one probably will not come back. So if you'll go to sallyhendrick.com/Kajabi, that is where you can get this deal. You will be so happy with Kajabi, okay? Again, here's the link. Now, if you have any questions, we can go into the Q&A portion of this presentation. And thank you, everybody. I'm cutting off the recording at this point, and I will see you next time.